Yeah, definitely enjoying it. Yeah, I think I've adapted well. All the lads made me feel really welcome straight away, so it wasn't really hard to adapt or settle in, really. Just kicked off straight away and yeah, really enjoying it.
In terms of you, it's a bit of a different environment going from perhaps being in and around
Yeah.
the first team at Rochdale to under 23 football. What's that like as a pathway and a journey to make?
It is different. It is definitely different. I think just the first team environment, it's just I don't know, it's just different to the 23s, but it's one that I like. It's a change, so, and like I say, I think I've adapted quite well to it, so enjoying it at the moment.
Yeah, in terms of the group you've walked into, a good group to be around and be involved with.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, definitely. All lads are top lads, and coaches as well, really welcoming. And now I'm fully settled in. It's great.
And in terms of settling in at Norwich from a player's perspective, just how have the coaches been with you in terms of your development? Has it been very much, because I know that the mantra here obviously is to get youth involved, has it been very much an emphasis on performances as opposed to results?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, definitely with the performances. If they always tell us if we perform how they want us to play our Norwich play, then the results will take care of themselves. And when we have done that, then the result has taken care of itself. And but yeah, they're always like individual stuff, team stuff, a lot of meetings. But yeah, it's good. They're just trying to improve all the time and really enjoying
It's an interesting thing, sort of prioritising performances over results. Perhaps not many academies and clubs do that in the country. From a confidence perspective, as a player, do you almost have to put your head above the parapet, I suppose, and take confidence from performances as opposed to results and take more out of those?
Yeah, definitely. But like we were saying earlier, that's like a big difference between the first team and academy almost. Mentality, if you get me. Like here, like you say, yeah, the performances are everything, and whereas in the first team environment, it's you need the 3 points. And similar here, we always want to win, of course, but yeah, the performance. But like you say, yeah, it definitely gives us confidence because they just let you play. They just let you be free and just express yourself. And yeah, it's good.
Let's move on to the EFL Trophy, then the game you're playing tomorrow. As a young player, how much of a good experience is it to test yourself against players of that quality?
Yeah, it's great. Of course, you've got the stadium, you've got the fans, you've got the evening time kickoff, and yeah, it's really good. It's a really good atmosphere. It's really, like I said earlier, it's a really good chance to express yourself and show what type of player you are. It's always good to showcase that in a stadium in front of a lot of fans and managers especially. Yeah.
Is it a nice change of pace from under 23 league fixtures?
Yeah, definitely. It's always nice to break it up, and they are different, of course, because we're playing first team games, so we're playing men instead of younger ones. So it's always different, and we just learn so much as we have in the previous two games, and I'm sure we'll learn again, and we'll hopefully take what we've learned in the previous two games into this game tomorrow.
It's been quite a young Norwich squad this play
Yeah,
for
of
this
course, yeah.
competition, so I suppose the education that you guys get out of playing teams like Portsmouth, Oxford and
Yeah.
Crawley is massive.
Yeah, definitely. Like they're three teams with such experience, such quality in League One and obviously League Two. And yeah, I'm lucky enough to have experienced League One briefly, but still myself included and the rest of the lads, yeah, we learn so much in these games, and it's a real good platform to perform and showcase what we can do.
And in terms of the Norwich supporters, I think Portsmouth clashed with Manchester City, which is perhaps why supporters didn't make the way down
Yeah.
there, but there's a few at Oxford. You must be really pleased with the support you've had in this competition.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, it's always nice to look over and see the fans, and yeah, we appreciate them and just hope there'll be a few there tomorrow.
And what are you expecting from Crawley tomorrow?
Tough test, like always. I mean, you see that they beat our first team, so it's obviously going to be a really tough test, but one that we're looking forward to and one that we think we can do well in, and just try and put everything what we've been working and what we've learnt from the previous two games into this game, and just see what we can do. As they say, play the Norwich way and the result will hopefully take care of itself.
Just on a different note, obviously Rochdale in the League Cup last week against Manchester United. How was that
Yeah,
for you to sit and watch that?
it was unreal. I was watching it wasn't on TV, so but I was watching it on a stream, but yeah, it was unreal. I was really, really buzzing, really, really happy for all the lads and managers.
And obviously Matheson getting the goal, were you aware that he was a Norwich fan?
Yeah, I knew, yeah. So, but yeah, really, really, really happy for Luke. I've been close with him since about under 10s or something, so yeah, I was buzzing for him. I FaceTimed him the other day and yeah, he's buzzing.
Yeah, it must be quite an experience for him to score at Old Trafford.
Yeah, of course, yeah, it's a dream come true for him. Really happy for him.